In my hand, I have one of the first Quest 2 headphone setups from BoboVR, unopened here, and this thing promises almost everything I had asked them to build in one. Different modes, power amplification, compatible with all different straps, not just BoboVR. It does almost every single thing I was hoping for. Always have that small, sharp unboxing knife whenever you're gonna open up a box. Safety first. One thing that has started to become more standard in the industry is off-ear speakers. It's even been what I've been using, these cheap, awful 3D printed Etsy things that I've had to now repair multiple times. You can even see a screw is sticking through them as we speak. But they're off-ear, which is really nice for exercise because you're not as hot. It's nice for immersion, but these things don't sound great. Bobo talked about how they wanted to try off-ear, but they tried a lot of engineering and everything with sound quality made it extremely difficult, especially without a lot of power amplification. So these are on-ear, but they give you two different options of ear cups to make them more customizable. So we've got, it looks like the smaller on-ears, so those ones are gonna sit on the outside of your ear, are what come installed, but it also includes the earmuffs, which are supposed to go around your ear, giving you even more immersion and comfort. $70 is what this set's gonna cost you. It's launching Sunday when this video will come out. They still won't arrive off Amazon orders for a little bit. Feeling them here, checking them out, first impressions. The padding that goes over your ears reminds me of Bionic Mantis, which was the first set of headphones I used on a Quest 2 for quite a long time, actually. It feels comfortable. It feels soft. I want to see what other accessories I have here. There's some instructions on here that I'm not sure what they mean, but it says thickening pad, so I'm guessing this comes with some additional padding so that if you're using a different head strap, you can adjust this part to stay on it. So we get the USB-C to USB-C, because this thing does require power because it's amped, so you do have to charge it. Let's check these out. So in my hand, I have a BoboVR M2 Pro head strap. I'm gonna try it on the Plus as well, but I got the Pro here ready with nothing on it, so let's see what it's like to just install it. Now, I haven't gotten any instructions. I'm just trying to see how user-friendly is this if I just try to do this myself. Slides over with only, I would say, minor difficulty. You kind of have to learn how to get it around because you're working around a couple different obstacles here, but it slides all the way back. It adjusts up and down, and it even has a mute function where if you put it up here, get out of your way, you need to take a phone call or something, it's gonna mute it. It doesn't have any, it has a little bit. Well, actually, no, it has quite a bit. It has quite a bit of adjustability this way. It starts off a little stiff, so you kind of have to push it at first, but then once you get it moving, it's not too hard to adjust it. I feel like it's got a good amount of adjustability, and I like with how high it can go up. When you're putting it on and off your head, you can put them up here, put it on, pull them down, so that's nice. Okay, right side. Now that I know what I'm doing, I think it'll be easier to install. I feel like that's not quite on there as far as I want it to be, but maybe it is. Are you on all the way? Maybe that's on all the way. It's got a really short cord here, which is nice. I won't get much in your way. And then you've got the cord that goes from one to the other. And it's got a little extra length, so I'm gonna try and see, could you tuck this in if you kind of wanted to hide it? Yeah, I think they've actually added definitely enough that you could. Hopefully it came with some charge. Pull down onto the ears. So if you have them plugged in, you haven't turned them on yet, no audio is, it looks like it's coming through, which I would expect that. So now I'm gonna flip the on switch. Whew. It's pretty overwhelming if you accidentally have max volume on, although it wasn't painful, but it was only in the Demio menu, so it's just menu music. It gives you a comfortable amount of pressure, but a confident pressure, I would say, on your ears. Like, I don't feel worried this is gonna slip anywhere or go anywhere, and it's hugging my ears. I don't feel like I would get fatigued with the amount of pressure it's using, but we'll test that more. And some people who don't like pressure, it might be just a tiny bit much, but they do have the alternate ear cups, which I wanna see how those work. This has gotta come off, right? Oh, magnets, magnets. How often do I say magnets make so much sense with things and no one ever freaking uses them? Smart. So yeah, they're just magnetic. You can kind of just put them on and then twist them until you find where they lock. There's three, so there's no specific position. You just have to make sure those three line up. Magnets.
Wow.
Let's try one of each. Now the earmuff style, they're gonna retain more heat. I do like them. They are comfortable. And if you were someone who thought these had too much pressure, this is definitely not gonna bother you. The only question would be, I'm not someone with very big ears, and these pretty much fit my entire ear in them just perfectly. So if you had ears any bigger than mine, you would probably find they kind of land on your ear and don't fully cup them, but I can pretty easily get my ear in there. So it's very close to 2 inches. Obviously, if you push the padding a little, if you squeeze your ear in there, I think you could get a 2-inch ear in there, about a 2-inch diameter. First impressions, audio is sounding really nice. In Demio, you can hover over the menu and it makes this little clicking sound as you do. It's kind of like a, almost like a two coins tapping together sound. And in some headphones, it just sounds like a clink, clink, clink. And this, it's, you can clearly make out what the sound is. And we do have all the sound modes to test out too. So let me mess with the sound mode button and see if it, I'm guessing it'll have to speak to us to tell us which mode we're in. Okay, so there's bass mode, cinema, gaming, standard. I've owned a lot of set of headphones that have those like different modes, and you try them and they don't always seem that different. They are distinctly different. At least the bass mode actually delivers. You can really hear the bass. If you're in Beat Saber and you're checking out songs, I like that. Of course, you do get a little bit more of that muffled because they are turning up the bass more. So it doesn't seem quite as clear, but I feel like I would probably use the bass mode for pretty much any sort of music. I'm keeping one on and one off to see if it makes a difference as far as the actual audio quality with how the earmuffs are working. So far, I think I'm actually preferring not using the whole earmuff. I feel like this feels really good, and it cups the outside of my ear enough that it's isolating the audio really well anyways. The cinema mode also is distinctly different. It's strange how it almost sounds like the audio moves to a different position entirely. It sounds very full and rich, but it almost feels like you have speakers blasting out from the sides rather than speakers extremely close to your ears. That's a really interesting transition there. The modes have me intrigued, I gotta say. On and off does have a single light to tell you, but it's underneath. So there's not gonna be much of a way to rely on, hey, I forgot to turn those off. I mean, at least it's on top. So it's pretty obvious if your headset's sitting somewhere, but I feel like it would have been nice if the light was like on the side or something here, because then if I saw it sitting somewhere and realized, oh crap, I forgot to turn those off, I'd go back over and switch them off. I think many users might accidentally leave these on a few times and have to really retrain themselves not to. Well, we've learned a lot from playing with them, but give me a few minutes. I'm gonna see what else this teaches me. 300 milliamps. They give you a time of endurance in here, so they're saying about 9 hours. That's about 3 full play sessions if you drain out your battery each time. I'm surprised that 300 milliamps is supposed to last that long. They call the small connectors that just sit on your ears the sports, and the bigger one the comfort. Although these are pretty comfortable. I felt like these were fine, but I've also used the Bionic Mantis and they're pretty similar. I got used to that feeling of something pushing on there. Well, we got lots to test there. Now Sunday, Bobo actually held off on their official release until we got back from CES so we could finish up this video. Let's talk final thoughts and some learnings as I've gotten to do a lot of testing with these. I went into this nervous. I really wanted an off-ear solution. I really thought an on-ear couldn't convince me to switch back. And I've got to say, these are now my favorite audio solution on the Quest. And they're gonna replace everything I've got. The stupid Logitechs I was trying to use for exercise, I'm gonna get rid of. The off-ear Etsy ones I've been using forever, I'm gonna give those up too. Between the clarity of the audio, the extra bass that these really do add, the stability you have, you never worry with these when you're moving them around that they're gonna pop off anything. They feel like they were built as part of the headset now. The different sound mode options, the look and feel, the comfort, I'm really, really happy. The only thing that I still do kind of wish, obviously one, I did like the feeling of off-ear because of the way wind could get in if you were exercising. We don't have that, that wasn't an option, but I really like these. I compared them to every other headphone solution I had, and the sound I always liked better on these. The Kiwis for a minute had me uncertain because the Kiwis seem to be really clear. It's because they don't have any bass and you really hear all of the high notes in that, but you put these on and the sound is just so much more balanced all around when you're listening to these. And after multiple rounds of games, exercising, cinematic experiences, everything I could try, I always found a mode on these that I liked enough. Although for the most part, I found game worked for everything. I actually didn't use the bass mode as much as I thought. I felt like game was a pretty good all around balanced solution. version. And of course, standard, you could even leave it on standard, but they're all unique and they're all different, which I really liked that in the sound because it felt like you really had options with those. One thing that I do worry, if you do forget to plug these in and you don't have a battery strap or something that you can plug into them, at least you always have the option. I mean, they have this here, you can just unplug this and let this hang and you still have your Quest 2 audio. So if you're gonna show a friend and you really need it to work right then, at least you still have that option with the Quest. It's not like previous headsets where you didn't have a choice. You had to have your whichever set of headphones and they had to be ready to go. Battery life seems to be stable. 300 milliamps seems to really last. They say 9 hours and I found I haven't been able to drain them yet and I haven't charged them again since I got them. So they're still going. I was thinking after this video, I'm gonna charge them because they've gotta be close to dead by now. And the only other factor I wanted to bring up is weight. You are adding extra weight. You are adding it to the sides. And although they grab your ears pretty well, the way they feel on your head, it feels like just more weight on your head. Doesn't feel like it's tipping your head for anything. It is weight to be considered. So let's see how much my Quest is weighing these days with all of its accessories. And let's see exactly how much we're adding with these. So right now I'm up to 936 grams on this headset. My main headset, which has an off-ear solution, is up to 1,087 grams. And now with the new solution, clocking in at 1,116. So it's definitely not a light headset by any means with all my stuff that I have on here. And that is something to consider. You are adding a little more weight. I would be a little more hesitant if you want to keep the stock strap. This is going to add more weight to that. And the stock strap is so bad at balancing. But with this head strap, I feel like it's fine. I don't notice that weight. Another cool thing, we'll show you a bunch of them, but I've tried even more head straps and I can't find a single head strap these don't work on. They work on the other weird ones. They work on the ugly, colorful straps. They work on other halo straps. I think I'm on number 8 so far, and I cannot believe how many straps these fit on. I really thought from all of the straps I had, I would find one that they didn't work with, and every single one so far has worked. Some of them you have to be a little more careful or you have to try a little harder because of these pads are so thick to get it in. I haven't found one. So if you get these and you find one, I'd love to know which ones they actually don't work on. And one other little con I found, for me personally, I preferred the on-ears. I stuck to the on-ears once I made that decision and I didn't want to go back. The over-ears are comfortable and they go around your ears, but I did find it's too easy to knock them off. So like, especially when you're going to put the headset on and if you try to like wiggle your way in here, you might get it in just fine, but sometimes if you hit it and you push, I don't know, I found them to fall off sometimes, even though right now, I feel like I have to try now to actually push them off, but I did find ways accidentally when I was doing it to push them off, and it wasn't a constant problem, but it was just enough that I feel like if you're handing this to people to try, you at least want to use this set because it's going to be simpler, or make sure and always move them up out of the way before you give them the headset. A mute function is built into these. Either side goes up, basically it's like past there, anywhere near this edge, and it mutes them. It's a nice feature if you want it. I don't ever do that. Even with the stupid Logitech ones that I was occasionally using, you could hear already through those because they were off here, but with these, if someone tries to talk to me, I just pull one out. I didn't bother pulling it up and trying to mute it. It's there if you want it, so I guess that's cool, but I didn't even find it necessary. Said a lot. There's not really much else to go over here. I would say, obviously, most people have a stock facial interface, or if they have one that's low like this. That big KK Cobb one that I had, sometimes this didn't want to get around it depending on which head strap was on it. So you might have to invest in a slightly longer cable if you have one of those in a head strap you really like and it doesn't quite fit. But most of them, I could at least get it around the front. I just wasn't gonna be able to go tuck it somewhere and hide it away. But beyond that, I've got to say, they've really knocked it out in the park with these. I should talk about price. $70 is not bad at all for how good of audio you're getting. But if you've already paid for a head strap, or if you hadn't paid for a head strap and you were hoping for a combo edition, that might seem like a lot to buy this and buy the M2 Plus with the charging dock. Now you're talking a couple hundred dollars. I would keep an eye out because I have a feeling they always make bundles. They'll probably make a bundle with some of these once they start to sell, but it is one more thing to consider. I think for $70, these are definitely worth it if you want on-ear audio. If you really are stuck in the world of off-ear, what I actually am gonna do, because BoboVR is awesome and they said they'd send me a set for Nat's headset, I'm gonna take one of these, and I found earlier experimenting, if I left it in there with this in the right spot, I could get it just right to where it would hover off my ear. It's not gonna be the most elegant solution, and I might experiment with cutting up some of the other rubber things they sent, or even cutting these up, but I think for my exercise headset, I can get them to just hover off my ears enough that I'll still get some wind flow, I'll still get that good sound. I don't know, I'll probably make a short or something on how I did that so you can see, because it might actually make more sense to cut strips and then put it in there. But I'm gonna find a way to make a just slightly off-ear solution for my main exercise headset. But for my main gaming headset, I'm gonna keep them just like this because the immersion too of having them on your ears does add something to your gaming experience. I really like them. But what do you think? You've heard all the goods, you've heard a few of the bads. I'd love to know what you think out there if you've been waiting for this. Or some people still say they're fine with the Quest 2 stock audio. But I will say, if you get these and you rock these for a while and you try to switch back, you'd probably have a hard time once you've heard something that sounds good for a while on the Quest 2. But I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments. I wanna say thank you so much for coming out and being here. Thank you, we just hit 30,000 thanks to all of you. So it's been a huge week, but I will see you in another reality.